the open method has recently begun to replace the closed method treatment due to reasons such as the lack of achieving an accurate reduction and the occurrence of occlusion problems. Open surgical intervention is probably more superior. One, you get an excellent occlusion and the patient is also rehabilitated quite quickly. So, since it is a postgraduate, it's a trainee conference, the theoretical part, you have obviously these distributions of fractures in various sites and condylar fractures. You can have condylar neck fractures, head fractures, and subcondylar fractures. I will specifically be dealing with the subcondylar fractures here, which most often requires open reduction. So etiologies, most of them want to go and probably want to put your gown on and start operating as and when you see. So you should always know when not to operate. So the relative contraindications will be when you find that a simpler method is going to be more effective, condylar neck fracture, then where the thin and constricted inferior wall, inferior region of the condylar head, even if you open it, is tough to probably plate. And you should not do an incision and then struggle for the plating and create a more severe injury than the injury previously. The parotid capsule was restored with 5-0 absorbable suture. So you have to get a good reduction and then a plating. A 4-hole plate or something is more than enough. So I'll usually try to first fix one screw on the condylar head and then try to align it properly. Otherwise, you'll be spending too much of time on just reducing it. But the fracture segment keeps going inside again and again. Then you align it and then...